So welcome to the class of financial accounting. Yesterday I gave you some notes on financial accounting, so I'm going to do a little bit of explaining of those kind of notes, and then we can be able to have a good understanding of the same. So I want us to start from the definition. What is this kind of what we call financial accounting? You know, we have various branches of accounting. We have financial accounting, we have cost accounting. Some of you have done the cost accounting. We have another branch of accounting. We have what we call the taxation. We have auditing as also a branch of accounting. And then also we have what we call the management accounting as a branch of accounting. So financial accounting is one of the branches of accounting. Accounting is actually a very broad course. So in this kind of particular one, we're going to deal with the branch of financial accounting. So financial accounting most of the time is actually statutory, meaning that you are supposed to prepare the books of accounts and also the financial statements, and then you present it. It's actually mandatory that you should actually prepare, especially once you have a company. You need to have those kind of particular books of accounts, especially the public company. So what is this financial accounting, and what are we going to prepare from this kind of financial accounting? So financial accounting, it can be defined. If you can be able to read several kinds of books, you can be able to see what they just call identifying, measuring, they have classifying. But I'll just give you a simple definition that is going to summarize the whole thing. So financial accounting is going to maybe just say financial accounting is the recording. Is the recording of business transactions. The recording of business transactions and summarizing them. And summarizing them into financial statements. Into financial statements for decision making of the users. For decision making of the users. So that's how you define financial accounting, the recording of business transactions. So we are going to record business transactions. And then we usually have two kinds of business transactions. We have cash transactions, and also we have credit transactions. So those are the two types of business transactions. Sometimes you're going to purchase goods in cash, and then sometimes you're going to purchase goods on credit, whereby you're going to defer the payment, meaning that you're going to pay later on. So these are the two business transactions. So it's the recording of business transactions. And we have said that the business transactions, we have the cash transactions and also the credit transactions. So it's the recording of the business transactions and summarizing them. So we are going to summarize this kind of particular transactions and summarizing them into financial statements. So after recording the business transactions, we summarize them into financial statements for decision making of the users. So first of all, we want to know what are these kind of financial statements, because what are we calling financial statements? So basically in your level, what you need to understand, we have three types, but now you need to understand the two. We have the financial statements, we have the income statement, which is going to show the performance of the business in terms of profitability and also in terms of losses. So we have the income statement, so the income statement is the first financial statement, and then we have the statement of financial position, which you usually know that is actually being called the balance sheet, which we call the statement of financial position. So the statement of financial position is basically the balance sheet. So that's what we call the statement of financial position, which is the balance sheet. So these are the financial statements that you need to understand in your level financial statements. These are the two financial statements, the income statement, which will show the performance of the business, and also the statement of financial position, which is going to show the position of the company in terms of the finances. How strong is the balance sheet? How liquid is the company? So you're going to determine the liquidity of the company through the financial, the statement of financial position, which is actually the balance sheet. So in advanced level, you are going to know another kind of financial statement is going to be the cash flow statement, that is going to show us how cash is going to flow in and out of the business, which is usually prepared in accordance with International Accounting Standard number 7. So the first two, we usually prepare it in tandem with IS1. So IS1 means International Accounting Standard number 1, which talks about preparation of financial statements. So IS1 is going to show us how should we be able to prepare the income statement, in which kind of format, and also it's going to show us how should we be able to prepare the statement of financial position, which is basically the balance sheet. So these are the standards. In accounting, we are always guided by the standards. That's why an accountant in Kenya is going to do the same kind of work with the accountant based in USA, because the accountants are always being guided by the International Accounting Standards, and also what we call the International Financial Reporting Standards, and also the RAPS. So we are going to know later on as we are going to advance. So we have this IS1, which is going to talk about the preparation of the financial statements. So we said that financial accounting is the recording of business transactions and summarizing them into financial statements for decision making of the users. So we have known the financial statements. Now we want to know who are these kind of users of financial accounting information. So we want to know the users. Who are the users of these kind of financial statements? So let me just wrap here, because I know now you are acclimatized with the definition. So now I want us to know the users of financial accounting information and their needs. So from the notes I gave you, you can be able to see that we had the first user. We may have the, let us discuss the internal users first. The first internal user is going to be the management. So management are going to be interested with the financial statement. So they are the users. So they are going to be interested with this kind of financial statements, which is, we have said that we have the income statement, we have the statement of financial position, which is the balance sheet, we have the cash flow statement, and then later we are going to have the statement of change in equity in advanced level of accounting, and also we are going to have other kind of statements like the fund flow statement, value added statements, several kinds of statements. So the management is going to be interested with the financial statements, so that they can be able to know. For example, we said the first financial statement is the income statement. And then the income statement, we have said that the function of the income statement is going to show us the performance of the business in terms of profitability. We want to know how profitable is the venture. The venture that we are trying to venture into, how profitable is it? So we are trying to know the income statement. Sometimes the income statement is the one that you used to call the trading profit and loss account. But now in the college level, now they have combined it. They have combined the trading profit and loss account into one statement that we are going to call the income statement. So the income statement, we are going to know the profitability, and the profitability is basically the performance of the business. How is the business performing in terms of profitability? How is the business making losses? Is it making profits, or is it operating under losses? So the management is going to be interested with this kind of statement so that they can be able to know the profitability of the business, and then they can make decisions in terms of budgeting. So they want this kind of information so that they know the profitability. And then after knowing the profits, they can be able to know now, this is the income that we have. How can we be able to budget in terms of making those kind of budget making decisions so that they can be able to know how are they going to allocate the funds to the various sectors in terms of paying maybe the salaries to employees, in terms of paying other kind of overheads based on the profit, profitability, and also maybe the losses. Sometimes it's not always about profits. Sometimes they may end up making some losses. So the management is going to be interested in that one because they want to know the profitability of the business so that they can make decisions on that. They can be able to budget, and also they can be able to make other kind of management decisions based on the profitability and also what the balance sheet is. Maybe if the balance sheet sometimes is not showing some liquidity levels, you know, sometimes the company may not be able to have some good assets, so that they can make a decision of actually ensuring that they're going to invest in more assets so that the company will be able to remain afloat. So you're going to understand later on that the statement of financial position, which is the balance sheet, is the one that the lenders use. We're going to discuss it later in terms of making decisions if they can advance you a loan or not. So the first internal user we have said is the management, and we have discussed on what they are going to be interested in. So the second user, who is actually an internal user, is going to be employees. Employees. So we want to know this kind of particular employees, what are they going to be interested? Why should they be interested with the financial statements? So employees, they want to know the stability. Most of the time is about the stability of the company. Stability of the company. Is the company stable enough in terms of finances? Does it have a strong financial muscle so that they can be able to know, is the company able, if it is generating a lot of profit, so that they can be able to ask for more bonuses? Is the company generating a lot of profit? And if they are generating, let us actually ask for more, or request for more, actually for more profits. So that's what we are going to discuss on that one, about the stability of that kind of particular business. So we'll be able to know employees, they want to know the stability, they make a decision whether they should actually continue working in that kind of particular company, if it is actually stable. And also they can be able to know when should they ask for bonuses. If the company has made a lot of profit, they will advocate for more bonuses. So those are the employees, and the main agenda that they are going to be interested in is about the stability of the company. So these are the two internal users of the financial statements. And then we can just move to other users who are external. For example, we can have the investors. We are going to have the investors. And investors, most of the time, are actually the stakeholders. Sometimes they can be called also the shareholders. Those are the ones who have invested in that kind of particular company. So investors, we are going to have two types of investors. We are going to have the present investors, So investors are going to be classified into two. We have the present investors. Present investors. And also we are going to have potential investors. So we have the present investors and also the potential investors. Let us discuss about the present investors. What will they be interested in? So present investors are going to be interested with the financial information so that they can be able to know if the company is actually generating a lot of profit, they will add more investments in what they have currently. So if they have 1 million, they may add another 1 million. So if the company is continuously generating profit, they are going to add more investment on that. So present investors, that's what they are going to be interested in, so that they can be able to know if they are going to add more investment, if they are going to maintain the investment that they have, or if they are going to actually reduce the investment from that kind of particular company, especially if the company is making losses, like the Kenya Airways. Kenya Airways, you can be able to see, is making losses year in, year out. So if you are an investor there, you can actually sell some of your shares. You can withdraw some of the investments, because at the end of the day, you are not getting the value of the investment. So that's why the present investors, that's what they are going to be interested in terms of making those kind of particular decisions, whether to maintain the investment they have, and whether they are going to actually they are going to add more investment depending on the incomes they have actually, depending on the profitability the company is generating. So, let us go to the potential investors. So, potential investors are investors that want to invest in a particular kind of company. Those are what we call the potential investors. They have not invested in that kind of company and they are interested. So, potential investors, most of the time, they are going to be interested with the risk inherent. The risk inherent. So, they want to find the risk inherent there, the risk that is associated with that kind of particular company. The risk inherent is whereby maybe you have poor management. So if that is the risk inherent, then they cannot actually be able to invest. But if the risk is manageable enough, then they can actually be able to invest. So potential investors, they are going to be interested in the financial statements so that they can be able to know the risk inherent. And then they make a decision. If the risk is manageable enough, they can be able to venture into investing in that kind of particular company. But if the risk is not manageable enough, then at the end of the day, they will not invest. So that is, those are the investors, and there are two, where you have said there. And then another kind of user, I'm going to discuss about employees. Not employees, because we discussed the employees there. It's going to be the competitors. Competitors, so that's another user because we did discuss employees. So the another use of financial statements is actually the competitors. So competitors, what are they going to be interested? Why should they be interested with the financial statements? So competitors are going to be interested with the financial statement for strategic purposes, so that they can make strategic decisions on how and what they should be able to do so that they can outwit the competitor. You can come with strategies of ensuring that they are the best, and you need, you know, when you have a business, you should always strive to be the best and also unique in terms of offering the kind of products. So that's why, as a competitor, we're going to need this kind of financial statements and then make a decision. If your competitor is making a lot of profits, then you cannot always decide what are the strategies that he's using so that you can do better and outwit him. So that's why the competitors are going to be interested in this kind of financial accounting information for strategic purposes. So another user of financial accounting information is trying to be the government. So the government is trying to be another use of financial accounting information. So the government is a user of financial accounting information, and the government is going to be interested in two things. First of all, it's going to be interested with the tax purposes. They want to know the income that you are generating, and then they tax you accordingly. So the first thing that I want to be interested in is the tax purposes. And then the second thing the government is going to be interested in is they want to see the business you are operating. Is it legal or illegal? The moment you vote for a license, they must establish out where the business that you are going to do. For example, you cannot sell weed. You cannot start a company of selling weed. You cannot start a prostitution company. They will not allow you. So that's why the government is trying to be interested in this kind of financial accounting information for tax purposes and also for the legality purposes. They want to know the business that you are doing is legal or illegal. So that's why they are trying to be interested in that kind of financial statements. So those are some of the users. We have the management, we have the employees, we have the investors, and also we have the competitors, and also we have the government. We have other kind of users, like now the public. What should they be interested in? Or the society, or the public? Sometimes they are also going to be interested with the financial accounting information. Most of the time, they want to know, like now you have a company in the village there. They want to see those kind of, you are generating a lot of profit. They want to see, are you participating in corporate social responsibility, CSR? They have what we call the CSR, which means the corporate social responsibility. So the public or the society, they want to see that they are going to be interested in that kind of financial accounting information, so that you can be able to see if you are generating a lot of profits, then you should participate more in what we call social accounting, which is actually corporate social responsibility. What are you giving back to the society? Like now Equity Bank. Equity Bank usually gives back to the society by having this kind of what you call the wings to fly. So that's why if the company is generating a lot of profits, the public is going to be interested. Is the company beneficial to the society? Is it helping us in terms of bursaries, in terms of scholarship, like now Equity Bank? So that's why the society is going to be interested, so that they can be able to know if the company is generating more profits, and then they advocate for more corporate social responsibility, so that you give back to the society, because the society is the one that you should serve. And then another user is the lenders. So lenders are the providers of loans. Those people who advance the rest of the business are always the lenders. So lenders, what are they going to be interested in? So lenders, they want the financial accounting statements, so that they can be able to know that they advance loans to you. Are you liquid enough so that they can be able to advance the loans? So if you are not liquid enough, they cannot actually be able to advance you. So we are saying that lenders are people who are going to advance you the loans. Like now the financial institutions, we have various financial institutions like the microfinances, the banks, the SACOs, those are the lenders. And when you start a business, most of the time you may not have enough capital, but then to advocate for loans from the lenders, but then to ask for loans. So before they advance you any kind of loan, they must check the financial statements. They must check the financial statement, especially the balance sheet, so that they can be able to determine your liquidity. Are you liquid enough? Can you be able to pay the loan amount plus the interest as and when it falls due? So that's why the lenders are going to be interested. They want to know if you can be able to pay the loan amount, the principal amount plus the interest as and when it falls due within the stipulated period. If you had agreed that you are going to pay after 2 years, can you be able to service the loan and then feel clear it at the end of the year too? So that's why they are going to be interested in those kind of financial statements, the lenders. So those are some of the users. You can actually search more. They have more of the users. that these are the common users that you are going to be asking the question in the exam, in the exam situation. So they will ask you the users, and then you are also going to identify the needs. So you communicate about your rank to answer the question by stating the user and also the need. Like for example, if it's the lender, lenders are the people are going to advance loans to the business. Then you are going to explain their needs. They are going to be interested by knowing, they want to know the liquidity of the company. Is the company liquid enough to pay the loan plus the interest, the principal amount plus the interest, as and when it falls due? So that's why what they are going to be interested in. So we are done with the users of financial accounting information. The other thing that now I want you to just, I'm going to give you notes on the same, is actually the qualities of a good accounting information. I want you to research on that one and give you some notes, then we can So for now, we are done with this kind of information and that kind of information. So thank you.